We was screaming through the valley where the Nishnabotna flows, through the mud and crud and cornfields where the marijuana grows, across the railroad tracks of Persia, down the hills and up the dale, past CJ5 with a four-wheel drive, Smokey on my tail. Well, he picked me up at exit 12 on the I-680 ramp. I was doing 67 per when I rumbled through his trap. He commenced to whirl his flashing lights and they made his siren wail. I slipped on down to four-wheel drive with Smokey on my tail. Now I got racing stripes and dual pipes and Smokey's got a Ford. Got a mill with a four-pot carb, you know, but Smokey stroked the board. Well, Chase is on by the happy edge with a brake that'll never fail. Got a CJ5 with a four-wheel drive, Smokey on my tail. Yeah, he was. Well, I dropped on down at Granny Low and I made a hard right turn. My big old fat commando tires went slicing through the corn. Well, the tassels blew and the kernels flew and it looked like yellow hail. Just cooking alive in a four-wheel drive, Smokey on my tail. Well, we went screaming through the valley where the Nishnabotna flows, through the mud and crud and cornfields where the marijuana grows, across railroad tracks of Persia, up the hills and down the dales. My CJ5 and four-wheel drive, Smokey on my tail. Look out now, here he comes. Oh, we're gonna get it on now. Don't hit that fellow with a banjo. We're gonna swim this here creek now, Smokey. Yard wide and 50. At least the bottom river, they call it.
Woo!
Might have to winch out.
Yeah.
Gonna do a wheelie on up there gopher mound now, Smokey. Can you dig it, Smokey? Got four on the floor and four in the air.
Sorry.
Goodness gracious. Well, that Jeep of mine made Smokey whine. His rig was made of lead. He's wired 14 feet of mud, so the radio to hit. I pulled up onto the blacktop, went crashing on through the rail. Sakes alive, I had 25 more Smokies on my tail. Now I had racing stripes and dual pipes, and Smokey had a Ford. Had a mill with a four-pot carb, you know, with Smokey's stroking board. Well, the race was on, but I had the edge with a rig that'll never fail. Got a CJ5 and a four-wheel drive sitting out back at the jail. And the kids was on a camp out in the mountains, and we had us one of them U-Drive Army Jeep cars, which we'd rented from a fella by the name of Kuboski for 30 bucks a day. Buy your gas along the way, take a rabbit's foot, and leave a pint of blood for a deposit. And he explained it all to us, how we were supposed to get to Telluride, which is 50 miles away by way of the regular highway. However, there was a shortcut, but unless we had drove the Black Bear Road before, we'd better be off to stay in bed and sleep late. Pay no attention to the guitar there. Well, we took up off on the highway, and we come upon a sign that says, Black Bear Road, you don't have to be crazy to drive this road, but it helps. I says, RJ, this must be the shortcut road Kuboski's talking about. She didn't pay no mind, because he was making peanut butter sandwiches for the kids in the back seat, throwing rocks and drinking Kool-Aid and playing count the license plates. But they wasn't having too much fun counting the license plate or cars, because there weren't no other cars. We went about a mile and a half, about 4 hours, busted off the right front fender, tore a hole in the oil panel on rocks big as a hall closet. Went over a bump, spilled the Kool-Aid, and Roy G. stuck his polo knife right through the convertible top, and the dog threw up all over the back seat. Peanut butter don't agree with me, see? So we had to stop, take off the top, air everything out, and clean it up. The dog run off, and RJ says she felt her asthma coming on. I was sitting there wondering what to do when the entire scenic San Juan U-Drive Army Jeep car sank in the mud at 13,000 feet above sea level. Well, we shoveled it out and ate our lunch. Dog made a yellow hole in the snow, and Roy Jean got out his Instamatic and took a snapshot of it. Mary Elizabeth drew a picture of the road. It looked like a whole bunch of Z's and W's all strung together. RJ took one look at it and said the only way that Jeep car is going down that road is over her dead body. Then a rock slipped out one of the wheels.
Move over to the left about 3 feet.
Right over the edge of the cliff.
Over there where I was at.
Doggone it, Roy G.
And
how many times I have to explain
it
to you? Well, I tell you to put a rock under the wheel, I mean rock. Now look at that, what you'd have there. No bigger than grapefruit.
Put another log on fire. Cook me up some bacon and some beans.
think I made it far that.
You made it a lot further than that. I think it's the driver.
And boil me up another pot of tea.
Then put another log on the fire. Am I gonna have to show you how it's done?
Come down off that hill across
the river. Yeah.
Your
bumper just took a hole in the sand, just like caught it with as he comes out. There he got up there. That's better. Now don't I let you wash the car on Sunday. Don't I warn you when you're getting fat? Ain't I gonna take you fishing with me someday?